This glitch is holding your project back. So let's take a look at the Explore page to see the trending projects. Let's click on the first one. And it's called Time to Wake Up by Brickplex. Let's just play it real quick. And yeah, it's an animation. Looks pretty good. What's happening? Okay, let's stop the animation. The animation is not important. Nothing here is important. What's really important is over here, the URL. So as you can see, this is its ID. And it's pretty short. It starts with a 4. And for reference, if we make a new project, this is what the URL looks like. So that's way longer than what we saw there. For that to be the URL, he had to have made the project like 1 to 2 years ago. Now let's look at some other projects. This one also has an old URL. This one, the same. And if you look at any of the projects over here, you will notice the same pattern. They all have this URL. Now let's try the same thing with the search bar. Let's search up Minecraft. And let's even go to trending right now. Old URL, old URL, old URL. So as you can see, even with the new projects, they all have an old URL, which means the project was created a long while ago. So why is this the case? Well, projects with an ID of around this number are not able to show in search results, and projects with an ID over this number don't show up on the Explore page. Let me just show you some proof real quick. Let's go to my project. So the Phantom Animator, let's go to my account, and let's go to my newest project, Duckpocalypse. You can see the tutorial for it here. So if I just copy and paste it in the search bar, I can only see my project and some other random project, which is not related to mine. But when I go back and look at the remixes, there are a bunch of them and they should show up in the search bar. Like this one has the exact same name as mine, but if I search it up, it just doesn't show up. So let's click it and you can see this one has a new URL. And that's because they remixed my project. Now this glitch isn't even new. As you can see, this post from 2022 is addressing this project. So here are the two tests. One of them had an old one and one of them a new one. And only the old one would show up in the recent tab and the search bar. As you can see, there's even a Scratch Wiki article about it. This has happened 3 times already. Twice this year. Okay, but let's just say you check the URL and it's old, but your project is still not showing up. So what could be happening? Well, your project could be marked not for everyone, which means the Scratch team looked at your project and said it's like violent or something. So this is one of my projects that's been marked not for everyone. And you can see me make this game in this video. And you can see it's not even anything really bad. Like it's just a super unrealistic gun, which is allowed in Scratch. And yeah, so what happened to this project? Well, if we scroll down, we see this guy says guns aren't allowed on Scratch, reporting. And then he reports some guy again. Still, there's violence. There's literally no violence. Like, these are blocks. But whatever, let's just move on. How can you check if your project has been marked as not for everyone? Well, it's pretty simple, actually. You just search up not for everyone, Scratch detector. And the first website should be from jafalo.net, let's click on it. And here it is, Scratch NFE Detector, find out your Scratch project review status. So if I just come over here, copy and paste my number, and that's called the project ID. Let me check my status, and it says not safe. The Scratch team has reviewed your project and found it to be not safe for everyone. As you can see, it says your project will not be able to show up on the front page, explore page, or even the remixes tab on the project page. Keep in mind, this review status may be changed at any time if they re-review your project. So yeah, this is true. If I search up the name of my game, even though it's pretty popular, you can see it just doesn't show up. And something like this, with only 52 views, shows up before mine. And you might be seeing this and think that's mine, but nope, someone just took my project. At least they gave credit. Okay, now back to the one with the ID. How can you fix that? Well, it's actually pretty simple. If you're an old Scratcher, then you probably have a lot of old projects lying around, like this one, which are empty. So just scroll all the way back down. And for example, we have this one, last modified 15th of July 2023, untitled 389. And there's nothing inside. If we check the ID, we can see, yeah, it's pretty old. And what you want to do is go into this project and go up to File, Load from your computer, and load the project you want. For example, if I want this one, replace. And now your project has been replaced by the game you made in your new ID. So, game's inside. And also, the ID is still the same ID. which means you put a project from a new ID to an old ID and now it can show up in the search results and be on trending. So yeah, I really hope this video taught you something. And if you want to see more Scratch tips like this, then click on this video.